How can you not be excited getting a chance to hopefully do the best work that you might ever get the chance to do in your creative life?
I was afraid coming around again for the second and third that it couldn't compare or that it wouldn't compare, and it's just been even more special.
There wasn't a moment that I wasn't looking forward to.
You got his kung fu, science fiction, philosophical, action, love movie.
The audience will just want more and more and more and more and more.
Never imagine in your life that you'd be working on a sequel to such a great movie.
Yeah, and it is the movie.
I've been involved in a lot of sequels where the story ended in the first movie and the studio would say, that movie was successful, let's make another movie. But this movie was designed as a piece of serial fiction. This story continued. The Wachowski brothers had it in their heads.
I did know pretty early on that they were thinking of a trilogy. And as soon as they said yes, I was saying yes.
I signed on without having read the scripts, which is something that I've never done in my entire career. That's just how much I trusted Larry, Andy, their vision, the story, the character, the company that came together to do it.
The boys give confidence and trust to the actors, and all of them just said, we'll do it.
I really didn't have any reservations. I really just had hope and curiosity. What are they gonna cook up, these crazy cats?
There was absolutely no question in my mind that I would love the scripts.
And when I read them, I just thought, bravo.
I loved Reloaded. Reloaded was just like popcorn. It was just so dense.
Hey,
you're gonna meet so many new characters, so many new good guys, so many new bad guys.
I get this phone call like, listen, Wachowski brothers are doing Matrix 2 and 3, and I heard that there might be a role in there for you. And I was like, sitting up here, 9 months pregnant, like, what? Are you serious? And I was like, listen, I'm taking yoga, I can do Tai Chi. Whatever I need to do, we're gonna make this happen.
Like, I'm there, I'll do whatever, I'll just let me in. I wanna be down.
When I saw The Matrix, I said to myself, wow, I would love to be in a movie like that.
We pissed somebody a lot of money. We slept our way to the top.
What can you see, Neil?
It's strange. The code is somehow different.
Is that good for us or bad for us?
Well, it looks like every floor is wired with explosives.
Bad for us.
The story starts about 6 months after where we left off. The machine army is marching on the last human city, which is Zion. And Neo has come into the fullness of his powers.
He's having visions. So there's things that he doesn't understand. The individual has left his room in his personal context and has now come out to a greater context of his community.
His arch nemesis, his rival enemy, Agent Smith, is back, shall we say, with a vengeance.
He is Ego. And he's just expanding.
Trinity and Neo, their relationship has deepened.
I missed you.
I can tell.
Morpheus takes on the role of a general in the army of Zion.
Soon the prophecy will be fulfilled, and this war will end.
They have managed to make a synthesis of so many different myths and so many different philosophies.
They're able to bring together so-called high culture, so-called middle brow, so-called low culture in a composite art form. You got 400 different levels in the movie. Some people walk away with 2, some people walk away with 50, some people walk away with 400.
Shit. And it's for the kids. And there's some cool kung fu, movie kung fu. Cool, and it's for the kids.
When the two scripts came in, Reloaded and Revolutions, it became very clear that it was just one movie that was cut in half. And it was made as one movie.
I was like, how are they gonna shoot all of this? They're gonna shoot 2, 3, and this video game script.
It was quite a feat to keep this all going and all up in the air and all these pieces and units working together.
No one's ever tried any of this stuff before. Well, how do you schedule it? It's never been done. Nobody's ever worked on this scale.
Pre-produce for a year, we're going to shoot for a year, and we'll have a year of post-production. It's a military exercise in getting all this together.
Sly and Andy are doing things that are groundbreaking again, which people aren't sure how to do.
It's gone into this exponential, not similar, but exponential level of complexity.
Well, the trick was we read the second script, and you could tell even then that it was enormous. But that's how we'd signed our contracts.
Upgrades.
Everyone involved from every facet of making this film, everyone has showed up completely and totally, and it's been really special.
There's a pretty extraordinary group of people on this show, and getting things done is like nothing I've ever experienced before.
Started training in November of 2000.
I just felt like I was kind of like in a dream a little bit. Here I am with Lawrence and Keanu and Carrie Ann.
On good days of training, we get the steam.
December, January, February, March, April, May, June.
8 months of training.
It's harder this time.
They have improved a lot. They have the foundations of the last time's training. So based on that, the result coming out is really ideal.
That shit is hard.
This time around, it was so hard for me. I broke my leg the second week of training. It's like every obstacle that could come into my experience of training came up for me. Probably one of the most important parts of that for me, and what helped me in that, was Keanu, because Keanu was so disciplined in a way that I've never seen anyone physically disciplined.
This one was twice as long, but probably 3 times harder, which is excellent. With the wire work, learning the weapons, doing multi-fights before I was always fighting one-on-one.
I remember seeing Keanu soaking in a tub of ice, and I'm looking at him like, you're in that four. He's looking at me like, you'll know one day.
The Wachowski brothers plan everything out in detail. Nothing left to chance.
The way that they tell a story, the physical action that they create, the elements of new cinema and technologies to create images are unparalleled.
I've heard Larry say it before. It's like, this is the most complex movie. To his credit, it really is.
Jeff Darrow, the conceptual artist, just a really gentle soul with the most incredible mind.
Stuff they only hinted at in the first movie, I actually had to come up with. It was a lot harder. The stuff that we would draw, it would give them ideas so they could say, I can now do this, I can now do that.
Storyboard is basically, a comic book of the movie.
Jeff and Steve could visualize what the boys wanted to see so that everybody else could get on board.
You know, there's like hundreds of people around. There's a million jobs to do.
We've nutted out the major look, and now we can kind of have fun tweaking the details. So I think everyone's enjoying that part of it.
We're in Los Angeles doing pre-production and visualization and planning of all sorts.
visual effects team, the photography team, the art department, the stunts team. We are all working in concert on these exercises.
Pre-visualization, we usually call it pre-vis, is a step beyond storyboarding, in that we can have an accurate depiction of the space and the time that the shot takes place in and analyze, can it actually be done or how are we actually going to do it?
You could have lens sizes, you could have how many cars that you needed, you could have the speed that the cars were going at. So you would get like a very clear idea of what you needed. On the freeway chase, it was invaluable.
They just have done such an incredible job in making the ideas that the boys conveyed through Jeff and Steve into reality. They create from nothing. Magnificence.
For me, it's an absolutely magical moment. The moment where you actually enter that world that a whole group of unseen people have been preparing, planning, and putting together. The things that Owen and Hugh and their crews have put together are just incredible.
Owen's sets are so fantastic that you feel like you're actually there.
We've got, you know, upwards of 150 to 180 sets, depending on how you actually sort of count them.
You hear a little bit about Zion in the first movie, but so much of the second and third films are all about Zion and protecting that purity of that world.
Historically, it's been a place where it seems to be impossible to extinguish hope, where there's always some possibility beyond the darkness.
The spaces that we've seen so far in The Matrix, very computer, very linear, to go from that look into Zion, this earthy, beautiful, tangible space.
It's this huge, cavernous, subterranean hall.
One of the most exciting experiences I've ever had on a film was in Alameda. And we had 1,000 extras.
All those beautiful young people who came with all this enthusiasm and these great open hearts and spent all those days there dancing around in the dirt.
To see Lawrence standing in front of those thousands and delivering these lines that are so filled with just inspiration.
Tonight! Let us make them remember. This is Zion, and we are not afraid!
I was playing to 2,000 people, and I could not pretend that I wasn't, and I couldn't just play for the microphone, and I couldn't just play for the camera. I'm an actor, I had an audience out there, man. I was gonna...
I love the scorpion. I'm all about the scorpion kick and the chop.
The fight choreography is beautiful.
I must apologize. For what? For this.
The work that Wu Ping and Dion Lam did is really remarkable.
The stuff that I had the opportunity to participate in, again, is just so ambitious.
The pain that is taken, The time it takes, people have no idea. You have people backstage pulling the strings. You have the people in the light doing the magic, and you have the people in the darkness without whom it is impossible to achieve.
Cut. Got that?
I think this is day 16 of the Burly Brawl. There were more movements in this one particular fight than there are in the whole of the first Matrix. It might actually be double.
It has one purpose, one move. A lot of fists, not many kicks. A lot of right-handed fists, because my left's sort of a bit... Mm. Come on.
You know, we were doing 18-second takes with a 180-degree Steadicam, where I have over maybe 20 moves, 25 moves.
Most of my scenes are either with Keanu or with me.
Me, me, me. Me too.
The Burly Brawl fight involves at least 10 of me at any one time.
One of the things that we've got to put a lot of effort into is the head replacements. There's going to be a lot of places where we take the stunt guys and put Hugo's head on the top. Just because there isn't hundreds and hundreds of Hugo weavings, we need to be able to make it look like there are.
There were 13. Sort of semi-me's running around. Well, I realize how far my hair's receded. It's normally I look at myself in the mirror and I think, yeah, hair's all right. But here I'm looking at everyone from the side and I go, ah! Look how far it's gone.
Where is he now?
He's doing this Superman thing.
What we're doing here is picking up little components of merciless pain and destruction that gets applied strategically through the fight.
A combination of physicality and technology, the way in which the action was ramped up, it's more than a notch. It's like several stories.
Bullet time was invented for the first film. Well, there have been certain things invented for this film in order to create something that was desired.
We would go for all CGI humans fully immersed in a CGI environment. We figured out the master plan for the choreography, captured all these little components, and then composed.
There are no cuts. The camera is showing you what it wants you to see while it keeps on moving.
All the advances that Gaeta has created and his team have created allow the action to just sort of mushroom and get really huge.
It was one of the hardest things I've ever done as an actor, because between action and cut, which is like action, cut, I have to start off intense Trinity girl to being shot, feeling that, and before you know it, like I'm just on intense girl, it's cut, you know?
The making of this film has been a very long technical exercise.
We've raised the bar so high there is no bar.
It's part of the magic thing.
Their whole thing is to push you that little bit farther. And as frustrating as it gets, it really brings the best out in everybody.
The day that I could do one thing was the day that they wanted to know if I could do two things. And, you know, the brothers would say, can you do seven things? And then I would say, yeah, I could do seven things as long as you let me try to do it 90 times. Everyone knows that they're being asked to do their best. To be acting on big sets and to be doing really kind of grandiose, sophisticated sequences involving real actors and then special effects elements or scenes of great ideas or great emotion, and to try and to make it beautiful.
builds. It builds, it builds. It's so well crafted. It's so well constructed as a piece of entertainment.
It's hard to go to the movies and really be turned on and like visually, emotionally, spiritually. That's why we all love making them, because we know that that is the truth of them.
That's awesome. In terms of playing cowboys and Indians, it's the ultimate.
It's just full of so much stuff, and it's, I mean, it's this great cliffhanger.